Everybody. Hope you're all well and welcome to day 8. I've just recorded all of opening my advents and then said a load of rubbish which I realised wasn't correct. So I've just deleted that and started again. So I will show you what I got in my advents even though I've already opened them. So Paula gave me these lovely minis, a chartreuse green one with rainbows and this beautiful saturated sort of indigo blue colour. And there was a Cadbury's caramel, chocolate and a lovely blue shiny. And then in Davina's was this lovely springy flower fabric, which will go in my spring quilt pile. And then this gorgeous Rudolph. And somebody said yesterday what a novel idea my charm tree is. And yes, it really is a brilliant idea. When Johnny saw it, actually, he said, I wish you'd thought of that. We could have put those in the shop because he makes things in wood. And it would have been a brilliant little collaborative project. But, you know, you win some, you lose some. And here is the bath bomb that was in my lovely package from Rachel today. And I can smell just a tiny little bit. Because it's wrapped up in plastic. It doesn't say what smell it is on there, but there is this bit here, which I'm going to open and have a look at in a bit. And I just wanted to clarify that Pippin's absolutely fine. And I realised that, you know, he hurt himself yesterday, but I did check him. He hasn't burnt his nose. I think he just got a bit of a surprise. And he's got one singed eyebrow whisker. But that doesn't seem to have affected him. His whiskers seem to be working fine. He's not wobbly or off balance or anything like that. He's eating fine, playing fine, being as mischievous as ever. So yes, I promise you, if he'd hurt himself badly, I would have taken him straight to the vets. But I've checked his nose. There's no sign of any burns or anything like that. Didn't want to let me check him. It's almost as though he doesn't actually want to be looked after. Well, that's cats all over, isn't it? But I did check his nose carefully after I'd finished recording. And he's absolutely fine in himself, so there's no need to worry about him. Yeah, up to his usual mischief, trying to make us believe that he needs more than one breakfast. He's such a barefaced liar. If I come downstairs in the morning and I'm not the first one down, he's around my ankles meowing and telling me that he's starving hungry, even though only 20 minutes ago either Johnny or Ivy have already fed him. He's like a hobbit. He likes second breakfast. Anyway, excuse me. Mum's got an appointment in a bit, which I'm going to nip her up to sort of just after midday. And it's about 10:30 now. So I'm going to get a wriggle on and process all the orders that I've got outstanding so that I can nip them to the post office at the same time and kill two birds with one stone. So I shall crack on with that and I'll catch up with you after I've done all of those things. What have you just done? Why is there coffee on my tablecloth? Did you just put your paw in my cuppa and then sprinkle it everywhere? Did you? No,
you are a cheeky boy.
Pippin,
naughty.
Oh, look at your poor singed eyebrow. You're not going to do it again, are you?
Mm. We're going to explore the laptop instead. Okay then. Are you doing that thing where you pretend to ignore it and then pounce on it?
Hello everybody. It's been one of those days so far where I've been scuppered at every turn. I managed to get things done, but it's been a bit like three times as much effort as you would expect in order to achieve a simple job. So anyway, I'm sat in the car. I've got half an hour until Cos comes out, but I've got to go back out. I was hoping that I'd be able to drop the parcels off at the post office earlier when I took my mum to for an appointment at the doctor's, but I wasn't able to because I needed extra yarn labels and belly bands, and then they didn't want to print out for me, and then the internet was being rubbish and I couldn't log into the Royal Mail website, etc, etc, etc. So I had to then drop everything, take mum, come back, process the payments. And the problem is that the post office is right next to the secondary school, who come out at 3 o'clock. So if I try and go there at about 10 past or 3:15, it's havoc. So I left early. And now I'm sitting in the car waiting, and I've got my knitting. Another thing that went wrong is that I tried twice to record my advents. I got it all wrong the first time, so I got rid of that. And then I thought, oh, I'll record it again and show you what I got, even though I'd already opened them. And I thought I did all that, but it hasn't recorded for whatever reason. So when I get home, I'll show you what was in them again, but like I've eaten the chocolate and put things all over the place. So I'll probably not be able to show you everything. Very frustrated. But I'm going to listen to my audiobook for 20 minutes and knit my sock whilst I wait for it to be time to go around the corner to collect Cosmo. So that should make me feel a little bit calmer and happier. If I've got enough data, I might even watch a couple of Vlogmases. Look, see that pink line there? I put my heel line in my sock yesterday, which was very lovely. But at least that's most of the job's done now. So when I get home, I'm going to sit down with a nice cuppa and some craft of some description. I've got a couple of things I want to make as little gifts. Not a lot, just small things. I might do a bit of that because it's pressing on my mind, knowing that I want to get them done. So yes, I might just tackle that. I'm just trying to think if I've got anything else to tell you while I'm here. It's a very grey day, as you can probably see. Not that cold. It says it's 9 degrees outside in the car. So, yeah, but because it's damp, it feels a bit unpleasant. Any road. I shall stop blathering on about the weather, because nobody really wants to hear that, do they? And I'll see you in a bit when I get home, where it's cosy and dry and pretty. I'm back from picking Cos up, as you will have already seen. Excuse the watch going off in the corner. That will stop in a minute. Any time you like. Right, anyway, I've come upstairs with a drink, and I've got this, which is the, do you know, I can't remember what it's called now. It's the Lurex type crochet thread. And this is a free pattern called the Helena Snowflake, which I saw pop up on Instagram the other day, and it's a free download. I've got it from Ravelry, and it's property of KAME Crochet, and it's written in US terms, but as I say, it is free, so I can show it you. There's not a picture, but I'll show it you if I finish it. So I'm going to work on that for a little while, and I'm going to watch some vlogs, catch up on Vlogmas.
and I'll catch up with you when I've done a little bit. This is part of my big bauble that I got from Anthropology that used to hang from the top of the up there in the centre, and the top part of it smashed and it was all jagged. But I got my little jewellery pliers and I very carefully sort of nibbled away at it. And I'm gonna, over the weekend, I'm going to get some wet and dry, and I'm just going to, because that is still a little bit raw and sharp along that edge, and I'm going to just polish it down with a bit, buff it down with a bit of wet and dry, and I'm hoping that I might then be able to put one of those bauble tops in there, glue it in if I need to, and still be able to have it hanging. It won't be quite as long because it won't have the pinky red bit on top, but I can still salvage most of it, I think. So that's something. I need to try and remember to get the wet and dry out. And I'm going to show you the garland while I'm at it. I've got the garland back in place. It's not staying there because the lights also got broken, the white, warm white lights that were on it. But I thought I'd put it up here just for it to be out of the way and so that it doesn't tempt Pippin. But I've put two very strong, you can't see them, it's hidden back there. But it's now hanging up there by two very strong split rings, like key rings. And then it has this, which is webbing, wound all the way around it. It goes right through to the other end. Now you can see it a little bit at the moment, barely. But once it gets really opened out and I fluff it all again, I don't think you'll see it at all. So that comes to the end, and I've put another split ring at each end and knotted it in a double knot. But I'm also going to put some stitches through so that it's with some really strong thread, so that it's, that knot's not going to go anywhere. I can't redecorate it yet because I need a replacement set of lights, which I've got on order and they will come soon. But they were already up, and luckily they didn't get pulled down, thank goodness, otherwise I would have been really cross if they'd got damaged as well. But the lights will arrive on Monday, and so then I should hopefully be able to put the rest of the stuff back. At the moment, hello, all of the remaining shinies are here in this bag, and I'd really like to get them back out of reach of naughty little paws, so hopefully it won't be long until I can do that. Right, I'm going for a nice bath now. It's much later now. I have moved from the bed. I've been up and made tea, sorted the garland, had a bath, painted my fingernails, a very slightly different shade of sparkly pink. And I thought I'd just pop in to show you how nicely these have worked out. They need to be a little bit, and they need to be blocked a little bit, but I'm really pleased with them. It's a really cute little pattern. I would definitely recommend. Anyway, I'm going to have a nice early bedtime, and I'll see you tomorrow morning. Thanks for watching, everybody.